Spinal adjustments provided by Dr. Chad Rolfson. The Spinal Tuning Chiropractic Center is a Des Moines area low flat fee per month unlimited chiropractic care practice. When life happens, just adjust. Schedule today at SpinalTuning.com.
Welcome to the Daily Planet for a Tuesday, July 21st, 2020. I'm Jimmy Olsen. 78% of sports fans want their professional and college sports back, even if the games have to be played without fans. Well, that's a significant difference when they conducted the same poll back in mid-April. In fact, that is a double-digit increase. The boat from Jaws is being rebuilt so it can research marine life around Martha's Vineyard, including great white sharks. It'll also be a subject for the documentary The Return of Orca. Julia Roberts and Denzel Washington are doing a thriller for Netflix called Leave the World Behind. It'll be their first working together since The Pelican Brief. Mindy Cohen didn't just play Natalie on The Facts of Life. She's also been the backup for Michael Jackson. Yeah, so in the 80s, she was in The Facts of Life. She was also in the studio recording PYT, and Quincy Jones put her on the song. Carrie Underwood is recording her first Christmas album. It'll be out in September. She says that this is the perfect time to do a Christmas album because it's during the most difficult times to be mindful of the things that we have and what truly matter. Blake Shelton and Gwen Stefani recorded a song while in quarantine. It's called Happy Anywhere, and they'll be debuting it on the Today Show this Friday. So have you ever thought about the actors who acted younger than they actually were? Well, there is a list of them that include Tobey Maguire, who played a teenager in Spider-Man. He was 26. Also, Florence Pugh, she was 13 in Little Women. Now, other people include Peter Dinklage as Tyrion Lannister in Game of Thrones. He was supposed to be the younger brother of Cersei and Jaime Lannister, but in real life, he's a few years older than both Lena Headey and Nikolai Coste-Waldau. Angelina Jolie as Queen Olympia in Alexander. Well, she played Colin Farrell's mother, but in reality, she's less than a year older than him. And then Jesse Metcalf as John Tucker in John Tucker Must Die. He was a 28-year-old playing a high school kid. Here's some random facts for your Tuesday. Did you know that Albert Einstein, Edgar Allan Poe, Jesse James, H.G. Wells, and Charles Darwin, they all married their first cousins? The 37 NFL players who with the most points in their career are all kickers. The 38th highest scoring player is Jerry Rice, who was a wide receiver. Lawrence of Arabia, over 220 minutes long and does not have a single line of dialogue spoken by a woman. That's interesting. The island of Puerto Rico was originally called San Juan Bautista, and the main city was called Puerto Rico, but eventually it switched. The island became Puerto Rico, and the main city became San Juan. Bananas contain about 450 milligrams of potassium. Did you know that? And about 0.01% of it is radioactive. So if you are able to eat 150 trillion bananas in one sitting, you would die from radiation poisoning. So the top how-to searches so far in 2020, including baking, cutting hair, and making masks. In fact, I had a friend the other day who just did a search on how to cut one's own bands. Well, other ones were how to use new software like Zoom, how to get stains out of clothes, tips and tricks for video games, makeup tutorials, how to make a face mask, how to get past a specific part of a video game, how to curl your hair, how to poach an egg, and how to fix a washing machine. So which one of those have you searched lately? It's National Junk Food Day, so what snacks have you been enjoying today? Now, the top snacks that people love, in fact, candy bars topped the list in 10 states, Utah, Three Musketeers, New Hampshire, Almond Joy, Tennessee, Baby Ruth, Massachusetts was the Crunch Bar, Pennsylvania, Hershey's, Nevada was Kit Kat, South Dakota, Milky Way, Louisiana, Payday, Minnesota, Snickers, and Wisconsin, Twix. Now, eight states love cookies. Oreos are on the top snack in Hawaii, New Jersey, Connecticut, Maryland, and Virginia. Chips Ahoy took the top spot in New York. Grandma's Cookies are number one in Missouri, and Nutter Butters are number one in Kansas. Now, various potato chips took first in seven states. Kettle Chips in Oregon, Lay's in West Virginia and Georgia, Pringles in Indiana and Iowa, Ruffles in Alabama, and Salt and Vinegar Chips in South Carolina. Now, a few more snacks that, you know, got more than one state included Fritos. They're number one in Delaware, Kentucky, and Nebraska. Cheez-Its in Arizona and Washington. Ritz Crackers came in first in Maine and Rhode Island. Michigan and Oklahoma love South Patch Kids. Wouldn't that be Sour Patch Kids? But we'll go with that. And then Starburst snagged the top spot in North Carolina and Ohio. And finally, the lamest snacks on the list. Wyoming and Dakota are both obsessed with sunflower seeds, and granola bars are number one in Alaska. So what junk food did you enjoy for National Junk Food Day? So the most ridiculous reasons people have rejected jobs. Have you had something ridiculous? Well, a guy applying for a restaurant showed up with no shirt and no shoes on. Obviously, he did not get the job. During her interview, a woman asked how many male employees were single. Probably not a good idea. A guy in a brand new unironed dress shirt forgot to take the pins out and started bleeding. Yeah, you know the pins they put in the dress shirts? Yeah, his eyes were also bloodshot when he showed up for his interview. A woman asked, "Does this place have a policy on drugs? Because I like to have fun on the weekends." A guy's cover letter was just a blank page with the words "cover letter" on it. I guess he printed it straight from the internet. It turned out that a woman applying for a job had dated one of the interviewers and ghosted them. Then on her way out, she stole a laptop. A guy's resume said he spoke French, but when they asked about it, he said he could only speak it when he's drunk. And a woman who wanted to be a police dispatcher had an outstanding warrant, so instead of getting the job, she got arrested. So the most ridiculous reasons people have been rejected for jobs. If you had a time machine, would you visit the past or the future? Well, according to 65% of people in this survey, they would rather travel back in time. 35% would rather see what the future holds. Happy birthday if you're celebrating a birthday today. You share a birthday with Juno Temple, who's 31. She was the fairy Twistletwit in Maleficent, Sally in Sin City, the Dame to Die For, and Violet, the unstable mental patient in Unsane. Rory Culkin, 31 today. Also, Diane Guerrero is 34. Vanessa Legends is 35. Josh Harnett, 42. Damon Jr. Gong Marley is 42, Bob's Marley's youngest son. Justin Bartha, 42. He was Doug in the Hangover movies. Also, Allie Landry, 47. Charlotte Gainsbourg is 49. Emerson Hart, 51. Brandi Chastain is 52. Lance Guest, The Last Starfighter, 60. John Lovitz, comedian, he is 63 today. Also, Cat Stevens or Yusef Islam, he's 72, whichever you address him as. And then Gary Trudeau is 72. Also, Kenneth Starr, 74. It was on this date in 1861 that Confederate troops defeated the Yankees at the Battle of Bull Run Creek, the first major battle of the Civil War. More than 50,000 men fought for 10 hours, while many of the pompous rich folk, dressed in their finest, came to picnic and watch the battle. To each their own. In 1873, Jesse James held up the Rock Island Express near Adair, Iowa, in his first train robbery. Only $6,000 was reported stolen, but it was more like $65,000. The train company did not want the public to know that they carried that much money. So on this date, 1925, the Monkey Trial ended in Dayton, Tennessee, with school teacher John T. Scopes being found guilty and fined $100 for teaching Darwin's theory of evolution. The conviction was later overturned. So on this date, 1954, surprisingly, France surrendered to North Vietnam to the communists. In 1961, Captain Virgil Gus Grissom became the second American to rocket into a suborbital pattern around the Earth, flying aboard the Liberty Bell 7. 1969, Neil Armstrong and Edward Buzz Aldrin blasted off for the moon after 21 and a half hours on the surface. 1972, George Carlin was arrested and charged with disorderly conduct and profanity at Summerfest in Milwaukee, Wisconsin, for using indecent language in front of wheelchair-bound children. This date, 1980, the draft registration began in the U.S. for 19 and 20-year-old men. 1987, Guns N' Roses released their debut album, Appetite for Destruction, which included Welcome to the Jungle, Paradise City, and Sweet Child of Mine. It was in 1999 Charlie Bride got his star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. That's been your Daily Planet for Thursday, July 21st, 2020. I'm Jimmy Olsen. Find this and many other podcasts on Google Play, Apple Podcasts, Spotify, and then find these stories and many more on social media. Follow me, my buddy Jimmy, at Twitter and Facebook. Also, my YouTube page at My Buddy Jimmy 101.